I want to talk about how you can install Laravel and Buify and get started, and what I would recommend for just the start settings. Because if you do this all at first, it might be a little bit overwhelming. So the first thing that I do is I'm creating a new Laravel application. So let me call it Buify. Cool. So now that I've installed it, I'm going to install the Laravel UI package. And from the Laravel UI package, I can generate this basic scaffolding. So, and just so you know what actually happens, I'm going actually to set everything under git control. Okay. So, right, let me add the we have a clear directory here, and let me now add the view scaffolding so we see what actually happens. So what happens is in package.json, view becomes installed, and you get some SAS dependency and view dependency, and you get like a starting SAS file. And in JS, you get just the default setup to work with. So yeah, the first thing we do is we install all the modules. That means that a node modules folder will be created, and now I can call npm run development. And then the files here will be compiled into my public folder. Okay, and they don't seem to change. Oh, now they have changed. That's good. So this is how it looks. It's not minified because I called the npm run development command. So, okay, and now what I would like to do is use this Buify component. So what we can do is we can use a full bundle like this. So we don't need all that. So, and on our homepage, let's just remove all these styles, don't need them. And remove all this. So I just have my app div. This is important because this is what is referenced here, element app. And then, of course, I need to include the script. So let's see. Okay. So let's check that we have this, and let's use a component here. So for example, the input, let's just use this. Okay, that should actually work. So, oh, I forgot I have to install Buify, of course. So I need to npm install Buify. And now that this is installed, I can create the run command again. So, and as you see, this is, to too large, right? We don't want to have a CSS and JS file of this size. It's okay for the moment, but I will show you how you can reduce it. So, but yeah, let's check out if we can see it. Perfect. So let me just make a small padding. And now we have a beautiful form here. So that's really nice. And that's how you can get started. And now I would like to give you some advice how to avoid having such huge JS and CSS files. So I mean, what I could do is, of course, I could call production and then it's minified and smaller, and this is how you should actually push it to production. But this will still be quite huge. So I'm not convinced that I need such high file size for something simple like this. So what you can do in this case is you could go to package. No, wait. Could do webpacks. And one configuration that you can do is that you can call mix webpack config. You find that in the Laravel docs or in the Laravel mix docs as well. And you can say, I want to have Vue as an external. I don't want to have Vue in my dependencies, so it should not be in this app.js. Right, if we do this, it becomes a little bit smaller. It's not the world, but a little bit. Yeah, that's because we don't have Vue anymore on our JS, but what will happen now is this site will not work, right? We need Vue. We need it as a dependency. So, I need to get it through a script. So this is like the learning purpose. You probably want a different version later. For production, you should use this one. So let's add this to our application. So now I'm also going to load Vue, and now I have it in here. So, but you still might not be happy about this file size. So what? Why is this so large? The problem is all the CSS from everything basically is included in this JS script and injected as CSS through JavaScript. So one good thing that we could do is we could extract the styles into another CSS. So I think this is the first good thing that we could do with Webpack. And whoops, this is wrong. So yeah, what we do here is we add the option. To say extract Vue styles into another folder. Okay, let's see what happens if we run production now. So as you can see, the JS is much smaller now, but we have a gigantic component CSS file. And actually, let me call this .css. Okay, much better. So we have now a CSS, which is far too big, and we have our JavaScript. And the next thing that we can do is we can call purify CSS and set this to true. What this will do, it will check for all view files that are in resources.js and for all blade files that are in our resources views folder. And it will check which CSS we actually require. And it will purge all the other CSS commands out of it. So now, if I run it again, the CSS should be much smaller because it only includes what we need. Okay, so you had to install purify. I run it again. So as you can see, this is really small now. Instead of 300 kilobytes, it's only 9 kilobytes. So the only thing that's left, if I refresh this page, it won't work. Because the CSS is not injected over the JavaScript anymore, I need to link the CSS here. So perfect. So this is the link. So if I refresh the page, it has a styling. So this is all really good. And maybe you find that the JS is now still a bit too big with 227 kilobyte. And what you can do for this is you can tell Beautify, don't load the whole Beautify, but only some components. So if we use this, and whoops, we're not going to include everything but only the input component. Now if I run production again, my app.js is much smaller. It only contains the input component, and the component CSS is also super small, and that's awesome. So I can load it and it doesn't work, but that's okay. So okay, good news everyone, I found out what was the problem. So as you can see, the styling is not completely correct, and if I go on to inspect element, I can see that there's still the B field tag. This means there's no field component. So the field component has not been translated. And actually, if you click on Beautify and input, use with field to access all functionalities. This means I have the field component. And I need to go to the app.js. And I need to call field, the field component. And now let us do everything again. So the app.js is very small, tiny component CSS. And if I refresh this, I've got the full layout because I only use two components. So this is how you can get the best out of it. Use this way to minimize the JavaScript file. I would also recommend in Webpack to extract the view styles into a different CSS, and the component CSS can be reduced by quite a lot with purify CSS. We got it from 300 kilobytes to 9 kilobytes. And Yeah, also I would recommend to not include Vue in your app.js, but use a CDN to load Vue, so people can make use of caching from the CDN, and in general they can just make use of caching, because whenever you have to update your app.js, you need to it has to be removed from cache. And yes, that's it. I hope you found this useful, and let me know in the comments if you liked it or not, and thank you for watching.